You're about to learn how to edit 10 times faster in the CapCut desktop editor using this and this. Referring to the finger. You see, video editing can take a really long time, and a common mistake beginners make is manually selecting editing tools with the mouse one by one during editing, resulting in the edit taking 10 times longer than it needs to. This is where keyboard shortcuts will save days, weeks, months, years of your life. By pressing a single button instead of going between the keyboard and the mouse constantly, your workflow is going to speed up out of sight, which is why it's a smart idea to set up keyboard shortcuts from day one to avoid wasting years of your life editing the slow way. So the shortcuts I'm about to teach you are the same ones you'll find inside my new CapCut keyboard shortcuts cheat sheet, which you can download for free down below for easy reference. So start by opening up CapCut, and up the top right next to share you'll find shortcuts. Click that, and up comes our keyboard shortcuts. By default, they'll look something like this, and these ones aren't great. They're not easy to locate, and they're not easy to remember. So if you follow along, we're going to replace these with the much better ones I'm about to share. To replace one, click the X next to the shortcut, and type in a new letter. If this comes up, don't worry, click override, we'll fix it later. I'll start with the basic shortcuts over here at the basic tab. I just want to repeat, you will need to change these yourself here in this window, so you can create new default shortcuts. Command or Control C will copy a clip. Then if you press Command or Control V, it will paste it. Command or Control X will cut a clip, which means it removes it for you to paste it somewhere else without creating a second copy. Command or Control Z will undo whatever your last action was. And if you keep pressing it, it will keep undoing everything you've done over your past few steps. You'll notice that all of these are pretty close together on the keyboard. This is to make it easy to use them with your left hand without having to go all over the keyboard to find a shortcut. The delete key is delete, pretty self-explanatory. Now I've set the E key to export still frame. This is handy for exporting thumbnails from within your video or any other kind of still you need. It's good to have quick access to export a still without having to dig through menus. Now if you head over to the player window, enter exit full screen is Command Shift F by default. I'd suggest changing this to just Command F to make it faster and easier. Now when you play back your edit, Command F, you can watch it back in full screen. Then escape to exit full screen. Now heading over to timeline shortcuts, and this is where shortcuts are going to be the handiest and save us the most time. So it really is worth taking the time to add these in. Now the first two commands are split and split all. What split does is it creates a split at the playhead over one track only, which is okay, but if you're an editor like me that likes working with a lot of tracks at once, and often you want to trim three layers at once at the exact same place, the split function isn't as useful, which is why personally I ignore split and go straight to split all. And I'm going to change that to S for split. Now when we're editing multiple layers on the timeline and we press S, it cuts through all of them at once. And from doing heaps of edits over the years, I've used the split all tool 9 out of 10 times compared to the regular cut, which is why it's better to give it a prominent place on the keyboard like the S key. The next two handy shortcuts are B and V. B is for split mode, also known as the blade tool in other editors. And this is essentially like a razor blade that cuts through any part of your clip that you click on. Handy for cutting single clips. Then if you press V, it will change back to the arrow, aka the cursor, aka select mode. Now the two keys I use the most of all of them are keys that will save you so much time when trimming your clips. And that is, if you scroll down here, you'll see delete left and delete right. Why are they so valuable? Glad you asked. Instead of having to cut a clip, select the previous one, delete it, just press Q, and it's gone. Go to the end of the clip, press W, and it deletes right. So right there, I've isolated the line I want. I deleted everything before it with one tap, and everything after it up to the next cut point, again, with one tap. Q and W are the MVPs of keyboard shortcuts, so definitely practice with them because they're going to save you so much time when trimming up your clips. And again, you'll notice Q, W, S, they're all within easy reaching distance of your left hand. Instead of having to go all the way across your keyboard for a shortcut, most of the important shortcuts can be found in this zone without having to move your hand, especially handy for lazy people. like me. Now, two handy shortcuts I've used a lot over the years are select forward and select backward, which I've changed to right square bracket and left square bracket. And what select rightward does is it turns the arrow into a selection tool that selects every clip to the right of the cursor on the timeline. Likewise, if you switch to select leftward, anywhere you click on the timeline will select that clip and everything to the left of it, which can be handy if you want to move certain sections of your video to another place. I've set M as the main track magnet. And what the magnet is it magnetizes all of your clips to the left-hand side. And say you want to add something between these two clips, press M, move it across, add the clip in, press M again. Yeah. For zooming in and out on the timeline, and I swear I do this at least every 10 seconds, plus and minus should already be set as the default shortcut for zoom. Likewise, you can also press Command or Control and zoom in or out with your mouse wheel for another handy way to zoom with more precision. Okay, but what if you want to do some really fine editing that is frame by frame? Let's say I want to make a cut right here at the very start of this waveform. To go one frame at a time, just press left and right on your keyboard, and I want to pinpoint that exact waveform. I think it's about there. Yep, that looks good. And then I would add a cut with S. For quick navigation from clip to clip, if you press up and down on your keyboard, it will automatically navigate to the cut points of your timeline, which can be a good way to go back and say remove one frame from your previous shot because you feel like it's one frame too long and you have to be an OCD editor like me to do that. And if you are, you can at least do it quickly with up, down, left, and right. To shuttle through your timeline in different directions, J, K, and L will essentially act as backwards, pause, and forwards. So if I press J, it plays my clip in reverse, K pauses it, and L plays it in the normal direction. The final two must-know shortcuts to add to CapCut are I and O, which respectively stand for in and out. Normally with other editors, you would need to set in and out points when exporting, so it knows to export just this section of the timeline and nothing beyond it, because often you can have extra clips just hanging around on different tracks, and you would need to do that, but not with CapCut. It knows automatically to export everything there on the timeline, starting at the start, ending at the end. But where I and O come in handy is if you want to export a part of your clip. So let's say I only want to export this part here. I'll press up to go to the start of the clip, then I to set the in point, down to go to the end of the clip, then O to set the out point. As you can see here, the in point and out point have been set. So now if I were to export that, it's only going to export that snippet of the timeline and not the entire thing, which is handy if you're editing lots of videos at once, or you want to export one or two shots to work on in other programs. So now that you've seen what all of the best shortcuts do, it's time for you to change them inside your CapCut. Again, it's up here, click shortcut and change them by clicking the X and then adding the new shortcut. I know there was a lot of shortcuts in this video, so if you need a reminder in the future about what all of them do, then you can download my CapCut keyboard shortcuts guide completely for free down below, which you can keep beside you while editing for easy reference. And while there are other keyboard shortcuts in the menu, personally, I don't find them as handy as I do these ones. However, if you think differently or there's another must-know shortcut that you want to suggest, let me know down below. And if you're brand new to CapCut but still haven't learned all of the functions of the desktop editor, this tutorial here will teach you everything you need to know to get up and running with it in under 20 minutes.